celebrating the festival acts.
A feast, a big feast.
And the independence.
It's called independence.
This year we have our 40th anniversary of independence in Solomon Islands.
Les explorateurs, ils ont découpé le monde pacifique en trois groupes. Le groupe mélanésien, les individus, la peau foncée, la peau noire. Les polynésiens, beaucoup d'archipels. Micronésiens, des petites îles, toutes petites. Les pays qui composent la Mélanésie, on a la Papouasie-Nouvelle-Guinée, les îles Salomon, Vanuatu et la Nouvelle-Calédonie et Fidji.
The Indonesians occupy the place from the West Papuans. West Papua were the Melanesian country, and they were the ones supposed to be with the other Melanesian country here in Solomon Islands. And I wonder why they don't attend the Melanesian festival.
Dance is about revisiting the past and connecting it to the future.
This we call Bird of Paradise and this we call Long Black Tail. And this is cassowary feathers.
Quand on parle de culture en Océanie, nous, notre culture, c'est quelque chose qui est vivant, quelque chose qui se transforme, qui est multiforme. C'est l'expression d'un chant qui part de la danse, de chanter, de manger, de raconter des histoires. L'homme, il est fortement imbriqué de manière très spirituelle, intrinsèque avec son environnement.
Dance is our original custom dance from
our own culture,
our traditional.
This is the kina. The kina is our money, the PNG money. Kina is the shell, it's a pearl that the coastal people used to take it out in all parts of Papua New Guinea. All 22 provinces we use this one.
This is the Solomon custom food, yeah? We always usually for time strolling, and this is they call fruit leaf, yeah? Yes, this is they call leaf. Pizza like this, lime this. Okay, let me make it real for you, yeah? Oh, the what we talking about.
This dance is about women and the husband.
when they separate. You miss the husband, a husband might die or whatever happens, and they separated.
This instrument, we thought just make him up from bamboo. This is a log cannon and this is a bamboo.
La question de l'indépendance pour les peuples de Mélanésie, c'est la question de sortir du système colonial.
They have been suffering and we are living here in a very peaceful and free life, you know. So how can we help highlight the issues that they are being affected by this?
West Papua, they are crying for independence, but the Indonesian government is not yet giving independence to them. They are still fighting hard for independence.
La situation qui se passe au West Papua, c'est une annexion de l'Indonésie après la Seconde Guerre mondiale, qui décide de manière unilatérale de prendre possession de ce foncier-là, qui est une île mélanésienne, Papou, et qui fait un tracé très, très au milieu de cette île pour dire que la partie orientale était indépendante et la partie occidentale était sous le joug de l'Indonésie.
The West Papuans, they become slaves in their own country. As you know, the natural resources like gold, forest, were supposed to be for the West Papuans.
West Papua, impacted by the effects of a colonial regime, Indonesia, that have completely deforested their forests. And so people in West Papua are dealing with both the impacts on their lands because of a colonial occupation and the additional impacts of sea level rise and other climate impacts.
We have the wider community here.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, this is our national event.
Yeah. They said whatever, anything to do with West Papua needs the police commissioner to give any permission.
It's not a demonstration, but more like an awareness that West Papua has been forgotten from this.
Where are you from?
Indonesia, province of Papua.
I'm from Indonesia, Papua.
From Indonesia, specific Papua, West Papua.
They told me West Papua was not coming this year.
We are here from Indonesia. Yes.
So what's happening over there?
What do you mean?
Like the conflict?
There's no conflict there.
We're happy?
Yes.
So sometimes we hear about conflict.
No, there's no conflict over there.
They don't want independence?
Well, there is some criminal groups that make problems, but there's no conflict.
Papua! Merdeka! Papua! Merdeka! Papua! Merdeka! Papua! Merdeka! Papua! Merdeka! 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 Merdeka!
there are no similarities between the Indonesia and the indigenous Melanesian people of West Papua.
Well, West Papua's been fighting for independence since 1962. There's been a genocide that's been happening on our doorstep, basically, where our government, for whatever reason, won't talk about it. Indonesian government covers it up. The only way that word's going to get out is by us having a conversation. In West Papua, it's illegal to raise a flag. You get 15 years jail. So this is my tribute to them, raising the flag 180 metres up in the Blue Mountains.
We have nothing against Indonesia, but we would like Indonesia to recognise that they do have Melanesian people and they need to be honest about the brutal genocide that happens every single day.
La situation qui se passe en West Papua, on peut faire un parallèle avec la situation qui se passait en Calédonie. On est un territoire français depuis 1853.
Aujourd'hui, c'est le moment de montrer qu'on n'a plus peur. Il faut lever la tête. Vous êtes chez vous.
Il y a toujours quelqu'un qui nous garde, qui nous guide et qui nous regarde. Et nous dit de ne pas perdre courage et qu'il faut se tenir debout.
Le groupe de chorale vient de la Nouvelle-Calédonie, dans le Pacifique. On est un groupe de Kanak, le peuple origine là-bas du pays Calédonie. Tout le pays se prépare pour le référendum au mois de novembre, où la question va se poser concernant le futur du pays, la destinée du pays. Si le pays va être indépendant, ou sinon, si le pays va toujours rester dans le cadre français. La Nouvelle-Calédonie, si jamais il devient indépendance, mais il sera le pays Kanaki.
Soutenir le peuple Kanak, qui va bientôt lui aussi devoir se prononcer contre l'État colonial, contre l'État français, pour l'indépendance de la Kanaky.
En Calédonie, il y a plusieurs ethnies. C'est tout un peuple qui est mélangé avec pratiquement beaucoup d'ethnies dans ce pays-là. Alors, c'est ça qui va être très, très difficile, parce qu'il faut poser la question, est-ce que oui, non, pour l'indépendance.
Il y a quand même un référendum Kanaky, parce que nous, West Papua, nous avons espéré kalian untuk mendukung kami lagi.
Est-ce que la France, du fait qu'on possède la quatrième ressource de nickel au monde, va nous lâcher si la réponse au référendum c'est oui? Je dirais qu'on a des certitudes ou les garanties, on les a pas. Mais en tout cas, la question elle a été posée au niveau du droit international.
As a Western, particularly colonial countries, continue to extract resources from the global south, what we're seeing is these disparate impacts. And so the Pacific Islands, there are folks from Africa, from South Asia, from Latin America, indigenous communities who are impacted by climate change. And those people often have the least to do with the problem. When you have a situation where because of climate change, hundreds of millions of people are being displaced, they're going to want to go where they can have resources.
The villages that live close to the coastal areas have to move further inland to plant root crops just because of the soil not being fertile enough because of saltwater intrusion. People are suffering because of this.
We got a problem with that climate change, water rising.
Some parts of the province is affected by climate change. A lot of our onshore habitats, they moved up offshore.
We should explain to our people, but we don't really have understanding where this climate change comes from.
There's a lot of gaps in terms of understanding what is causing all of these changes for communities that barely burn fossil fuel at all. Some of them have never seen a car. The cruel irony of climate change is that the countries that have done the least to cause it are going to suffer first and the most severe impacts. These are communities that have lived for thousands of years here in Melanesia and kept their culture intact, living in harmony with the sea, with their island, with their entire sort of natural environment. And to suddenly have all of that under threat because of some distant countries burning fossil fuels is a very sort of harsh shock for them.
The burning of fossil fuels, and when I say fossil fuels, I mean the burning of coal, oil, and gas. This is leading to increases in greenhouse emissions. This has been happening for decades. And we're now at a point where the Earth has warmed so much, sort of above what it normally is supposed to warm. This is leading to the melting of ice caps, which in return means the rising of sea levels. And for low-lying lands and islands, so for example, islands in the Pacific that are only 1 meter or 2 meters above sea level are seeing their lands start to disappear and therefore their livelihoods start to disappear.
When it's high tide, the sea always come up. Sometimes it come in the village.
I think in few years, maybe relocation, and people will evacuate to highlands.
But they already are moving because of climate changes. It just is not happening in one big wave like we're seeing in the Syrian crisis. This is happening more in drips and drops.
By 2050, there will be over 200 million people who have been displaced or will have to migrate because of climate change.
There's been a massive increase in sort of security and border patrols and closing borders. And in large part, this is a response to the predicted waves of refugees that we're going to see as a result of climate change, that our governments are pulling up the drawbridge right at the moment when we should be extending the hand.
Pacific climate worries consist of countries around the Pacific. We try to campaign and tell the world that we want to move away from the fossil fuel to the renewable energy. We are the